So today our topic is class 5 restorations. As you know, the class 5 liens, these class 5 liens are occurring on the cervical areas, the gingival third, you can say, of the tooth structure, and it's involved all the circumferentially, the buccal surface or lingual surface. So these are the class 5 liens. They could be caries or they could be non-caries cervical liens. The difference between the caries and non-caries cervical liens are that the caries is induced by, as you know, that acid which is produced by the bacteria. And these are the plaque bacteria which is present in the plaque and with the metabolize the carbohydrates to produce the acid. And that acid demineralize the tooth structure and produce a cavity that we call the caries cavity. And the other or the non-caries liens could be the loss of the tooth structure due to other reasons. And there are the other reasons, you know, there could be abrasion, abfraction, or the erosion. Erosion again, acid induced, but this acid is not produced by the bacteria as in case of the dental caries. So that acid could be intrinsic acid or could be the extrinsic acid, as we will discuss what could be the causes or etiology of these non-caries cervical liens. Mostly we in this topic will focus on the non-caries cervical liens. The caries liens or could be treated, as we discussed earlier, that if in the topics of the caries. And here you can see these non-caries cervical lien at the area of the cervical area, the buccal surface of these premolars. And you can see occlusal fossates are also present on that occlusal surface or the on the teeth. And these cervical area, these are the molar areas. A molar area, you can see a V-shaped liens are there. Loss of the tooth structure at the cervical area, and it's producing the wedge or V-shape liens or cavitations. It's a loss of the tooth structure. It could be the different causes of the loss of the tooth structure. As you can see, a thickened gingiva surrounding these liens at the cervical area, a thick band of the attached gingiva. Due to this, some reasons could be abrasion or other things. So the surface at the cervical area loss. In this case, you can see here a very deep lien of this involving this maxillary canine, and the very deeply and V shape again, and that could be even sometimes involving the pulp even very deeply, or some more deep that could cause the fracture of the tooth structure here, and the loss of the tooth. So these are the cervical liens. We mostly call them non-caries cervical liens, or the NCCLs. So these liens have different etiological factors and different options of the restorations. And here you can see again these maxillary incisors. And these maxillary incisors are here showing the tooth structure loss because of these same cervical non-caries cervical liens. And here you can see these liens having cervical area in the enamel, this intra-enamel liens. So these different presentations of these non-caries cervical liens, they may be involving a single tooth, or sometimes a group of the teeth are involved. So this could be a problem may occur if you not treat these liens. Then what will happen if we fail to treat the NCCLs? the progressive loss of the tissue structure, as the loss will continue, and as I told you, they involve the pulp even. They're sometimes so severe or deeper that tooth structure could be lost, as mostly the fracture occur due to the thinning of the at the cervical area. This become thin, and so tooth may loss even. The tooth sensitivity initially when it involving the areas, so in exposing the root surface, sometimes mostly the gingival recession could be there. The root A exposed and dentine exposed, that could leads to the sensitivity, and mostly the patients coming with the complaint of this sensitivity, they feel sensitivity especially on cold. Jo patient ki jo complaint hoti hai wahi hai, yahi hoti hai. And when you examine the patient, you will find these kind of the lesions present at the cervical areas. So it's a sensitivity, mostly the generalized sensitivity patient ki jo complaint hoti hai ki thanda lete hain to pure muh mein lagta hai, feel hota hai thanda is tarah se. Yeah, and I'm during eating the ice creams and these things. So that is the sensitivity, generalized sensitivity complaint of the patient. Need for endodontic treatment at very deeper lesion, they involve the pulp, and that leads to the endodontic problem. And then of course the root canal treatment, all these things. Loss of tooth, if the fracture tooth could be lost. Occurrence of additional lesions, actually not the etiological factor will there and involving the other teeth as well. So this is that's why the non-caries cervical lesions needs to be treated as early as possible. Now the etiological factors, as we know that this is mostly not a single etiological factor involved. And it is confirmed that it's a multifactorial problem, and it's a multi etiological actors and factors, they act together and then produce this kind of the lesions. So most commonly, as we know, that this is called what we call the abrasion and the mechanical surface loss of tooth surface. And then mechanically, mostly we use the in for cervical areas, the toothpaste and toothbrush abrasion, and mostly the abrasive toothpaste we use were with the brushes, hard brushes, or these hard brushing may leads to the loss of the tooth surface, and that is we call the abrasion. So that may mostly these abrasive lesions due to the toothbrushing and toothpaste may involve some group of the teeth, and mostly sometimes if the patient's right-handed toothbrush, the mostly it's brushing in the left side and in a horizontal area. So it's not could be a generalized, but there are certain teeth may be more exposed to hard toothbrushing, and that leads to that surface loss. Occlusal force is what we call the abfraction. Occlusal force is what we call the stress corrosion as well, or abfraction. When there the tooth are under the occlusal forces, and mostly the occlusal heavy forces, that may lead to the flexion of the tooth at the cervical area, and that flexure lead to the fracture of the enamel at the cervical area, and ultimately lead to the loss of the tooth structure. But it has been observed that the abfraction occur when there is a low pH in the oral cavity, what we call the erosion of the tooth surface due to the acidic environment. So low pH ho agar patient is taking some, you know, extrinsic acidic liquids or foods or diets like that will decrease the low pH, or sometimes intrinsic with the patients having the gastric problems, and in these cases the pH of the oral cavity remain a bit low, and that cause the softening of the tooth structure. And when that tooth structure comes under the forces, that forces leads to the fracture of the tooth structure, and a micro fracture we call at the cervical area, and then exposing the dentine, and then when dentine exposed, then the abrasive forces even could be there. The diet abrasive forces are the brushing forces that will lead to loss of the tooth structure in the cervical area. So this is the, how that theory say that it is there, the multi factors are involved, and that multi factors, it's not a single factor which leads to these kind of the lesions. So we need to identify these lesions and then and these etiological factors, and then be treatment. But it is a multifactorial problem. And here you can see what we call the abfraction theory. As I told you, that abfraction theory due to the forces, as here you can see forces when they come contact to each other, the teeth in a occlusion or in during the lateral excurrence movements, that may cause the forces. Here, as you can see, a micro fracture of the enamel. This is cemento enamel junction, the dentine, and this micro fracture of enamel ultimately leads here at jo niche aap dekh rahe hain, the figure was showing the loss of the enamel and exposing the dentine. And this is we call the abfraction theory. And here in abfraction theory, if you check the patient, when the patient will find the multi cervical lesions, especially in the posterior area, and occlusal jo tooth surface loss could be there, occlusal fossets could be present. The patient may having, you can see some other jo bruxism, like these are other occlusal problem could be evident. So you can identify that could be occlusal forces may involve in these kind of the cervical lesion. Then occlusal therapy, and you can take the measures to avoid this occlusal forces on the teeth. So this is the abfraction theory, and mostly the theory which mostly believed that this could act in this non-carious cervical lesions. But it is also, as I told you, that the only if there's a pH is normal and only the occlusal forces has hardly produced these cervical lesion. But when there is acidic environment in neural cavity, these forces may lead to this lesions. Treatment approaches, as I told you, the first thing is that you have to identify the etiological factors, which factors are involved. The occlusal forces, the acidic environment, and if it is acidic environment, it's the intrinsic acids, it's the extrinsic acids, or controlling the, and this could be other mechanical problems like your tooth brushing, your hard toothbrush, or your toothpaste mostly that contain the particle size. Sometimes these toothpaste, as you know, that more commercially available toothpaste which are claiming the whitening of the teeth and all that, they have a more abrasive particles. So to when they brushing it, these toothpaste having abrasive particles, so removing the plaque and staining, but can remove the surface as well. So these factors you have to identify. Then it's a bit then we make your job easy to treat the lesion. So controlling the etiological factor is when you identify, then you can control it. Okay. For example, if the brushing of the tooth is a problem, you identify that it's mainly the primary problem is the brushing, and toothpaste. So you can educate the patient to change the brush or to change the toothpaste and all these things. If patient's having a diet like this, which is having a taking more juices, fruits, or acetic or citric acid fruits, or like this diet, or cold drinks, so you can also educate the patient that these are the factors which leads to these kind of lesions, and then you should avoid. Or if you have an intrinsic gastric problem, patient go. So then again, you can counsel the patient, and you can refer the patient to the medical practitioner that they control this intrinsic problem which produce the acidic environment and oral cavity and leads to the softening effect of the tooth structure and ultimately loss of tooth structure. So that is the and if it is occlusal problem, patients having occlusal therapy, then you can go for occlusal or जो हम स्प्लिंट देते हैं. तो दिस दीज ऑल यू हैव टू चेक द फैक्टर्स एंड देन कंट्रोल द फैक्टर्स एंड देन देयर कुड बी अ रेस्टोरेटिव ट्रीटमेंट. नाउ मेजर, जैसे मैंने कहा कि प्रॉब्लम पेशेंट्स हैव ए चीफ कंप्लेन हियर, स्पेशली इन अर्ली स्टेजेस, दैट इज योर डेंटिन हाइपर सेंसिटिविटी एंड इट इज अ जनरलाइज्ड एंड इट्स सम टाइम अ वेरी problematic for patient, even for dentist to treat this hypersensitivity. The patient बार बार आते हैं और ये लिया वो लिया everything again the dentine sensitivity is there. So there are the some solutions are there. Sealing of the, as you know, the dentine hypersensitivity, the theory of dentine hypersensitivity, hydrodynamic theory mostly. It's a valid theory that we know that there are dentinal tubules which contain the fluid in dentinal tubules. So once they are exposed to the different environment like cold or like hot, and that can lead to the expansion or the contraction depend upon the temperature of your fluid. That fluid movement may produce or irritation at contraction or expansion or flow of the inward or outward movement of this fluid leads to the nerve endings which present at the beginning of the pulp and dentine. So that may produce the irritation of these nerves and induce this sensitivity. And these nerves are mostly A delta fibers. As you know, they are present at the periphery of the pulp and they are the very sharp fast conducting fibers. So these conduct this sensitivity. So it is actually the tubules which contain the fluid inside, the fluid which present inside the these tubules. We need to seal these tubules. If you seal the tubules, then we can control this hypersensitivity. So sealing of dentinal tubules, as here you can see here, self-etching dentine bonding agents are most effective. Expose to root surface area. First you have to polish the surface, and there's no need to etch if they are self-etching, and then polish it and dry it, isolate it, and apply this dentine bonding agent directly over the exposed dentine, where you find that could be a source of the sensitivity. So you apply this dentine bonding agent over it, and that will seal the dentine. As you know, how they seal the we discussed all this mechanism of dentine bonding agent with the dentine. So fluoride gels or varnishes are also can be applied. The fluoride gels of varnishes are available which contain the high fluoride rate. These fluoride again causing the blocking of the tubule center. So these desensitizing toothpaste containing the 8% arginine and calcium carbonate, calcium carbonate, these all the what called that desensitizing desensitizing toothpaste could be prescribed to the patient. Why we need to restore this जो मेनली जो ट्रीटमेंट है रेस्टोरेशन है, रेस्टोरेशन करेंगे जो लियंस हैं, यू हैव टू रीस्टोर द लियन. सो वाई वी नीड टू रीस्टोर द लियंस डिस्कस हेयर करेंगे. अब पहले भी मैंने कहा कि इफ यू डोंट ट्रीट द लियन वॉट विल हैपन. So we need to restore the lien as well, because inability to eliminate or gradually reduce the rate of lien progress through the elimination of etiological factors. So you examine kar rahe hain hum, aur lien slowly progressing, even you control the etiological factor, but lien is there and it's प्रोग्रेसिव एस्थेटिक है पेशेंट को एक्सपोजिंग टू इवेंट के सर्वाइकल लियन इज देयर सो पेशेंट्स अन यू नो अनएस्थेटिक एंड सो दैट कुड नीड रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ द लियन सिग्निफिकेंट सेंसिटिविटी है जो अप्लाइड ऑल द डिसेंसिटाइजिंग जो हमने डिस्कस किया इंस्टेड ऑफ दैट देयर इज अ सेंसिटिविटी सो दैट नीड्स द रेस्टोरेशन and that sensitivity could be the cold to the liquids or foods or air a threat to strength of tooth integrity of the corono radicular unit because of the lesion depth as earlier we discussed that with a deep caries or these lesions which leads to the loss of the tooth structure cervical area and very deeply involving the area and could cause the fracture of the tooth structure at the coronal or radicular junction so that's why we need to restore for restoration there must be access and isolation as you know these lesions are more close to the gums and sometimes even subgingivally they are present even the caries or non-caries cervical lesions so it's a problem to get the access to remove all the lesion or to restore all the lesions margins to expose the margins of the lesions because sometimes they are close to the gingiva and they are sometimes subgingival and then isolation is important for doing restoration it is a GIC restoration or it is your composite restoration you must need to do the isolation so isolation could be a problem here because of two things one is the gingiva is there could be a bleeding from the gingiva that blood can cause the contamination of the surface or there is a gingival fluid even is there the gingival fluid is causing the contamination of the tooth structure so you need these two things importantly before doing the restoration as here you can see that tooth structure here this composite restoration has been done in this cervical area and patient comes with the gingival swelling or what you would call simply the gingivitis as you can see a swollen gingiva is there and red gingiva and some bleeding is there on probing is there so what is the problem with this patient after restoration if there is a gingival problem so it could be a problem because of a poor access the margins could be overhanged and this overhanged margins leads to the gingival problem here you can see in other picture here we after giving this retraction card to expose the area you can see here a cervical area this tooth structure and these are the margins of the composite as you can see here composite margins are overhanged and that composite margin overhanged composite margin it leads to the gingival problem so that's why the access is important when you doing restoration of the cervical area that these overhanged restoration should be avoided and that contouring should be done properly for the sake of the health of the gingival tissues so for access what there are the techniques or the methods one is now what called the non-surgical retraction of the gingival tissue to expose the area to get the access to the area as this you can see here a clamp is used that clamp we called it 212SA clamp this is a cervical for class 5 the clamp that clamp is used to retract the tissues gums and expose the cervical or the lesions especially gingival margins so this is the here again you can see this clamp is used to expose the cervical margins and then it is easy to restore this okay so these clamps are used this is 212SA clamp and 212SA clamp is used this और बटरफ्लाई शेप भी इसको हम कहते हैं, बटरफ्लाई शेप क्लैम इज यूज्ड इन मोस्टली इन एंटीरियर टीथ टू एक्सपोज दिस सर्वाइकल एरिया. दिस इज क्लैम वी यूज और समटाइम्स इट इज सो सबजेंजिवली. देन वी यूज व्हाट वी कॉल द मिनी फ्लैप. A mini flap here, you can see this slight incision is given here in a mesial area and in a distal area to just loosen this gingiva, that you can retract the gingiva, and then you can see here a gingiva is retracted, and then you apply the same butterfly shaped clamp or what we call the 212 clamp, and that clamp again retract this gingiva, and of rubber dam is applied for isolation. So exposing the cavity and gingival margins are all exposed. The access now it's easy, and then you can do restoration and all that easy and in a contouring way and polishing the restoration. That's very important here. This should be a polished because close to the gums, if the plaque retention could be there due to the rough surface or over contoured. Overhang restoration that will lead to the gingivitis, or sometimes we do the gingivoplasty, or what we call the gingivectomy. As here, this you can see a lesion. This is a carious lesion, class 5 lesions. It's close to the gums and subgingival. Even margins are there. Margins are not exposed fully gingivally, so we need to retract it to expose the gingiva. Or sometimes it's over, you know, the gingiva could be growth, overgrowth. That could be after gingivectomy. You can see here a gingivectomy is done, and that gingivectomy, after gingivectomy, the exposed area here you can see a very clear area, and that we you could you do the restoration and remove this old restoration, remove the caries, and you can do the restoration. So gingivectomy sometimes could be. Here you can see a restoration is done. This is cephaly restoration with composite restoration, and after healing of this, after gingivectomy, you can see a very smooth, fully restored anterior teeth. So that is the how you can do. If gingivectomy only, it is over plastic or hyperplastic gingiva is there, or the overgrowth gingiva is there, then you can do the gingivectomy, or otherwise there could be other what we call the conventional flap even given. Here you can see a multiple teeth are involved, and in anterior area these are class 3 cariously. So in these multiple teeth, carious teeth, here you can see a conventional flap. Aap isme dekh sakte hain, sometime hum vertical incision देते हैं. समटाइम्स जरूरी नहीं है वर्टिकल इंसिशन की, ओनली द हॉरिजॉन्टल इंसिशन इज गिवन, एंड देन इट इज यू कैन रिट्रैक्ट द फ्लैप एंड एक्सपोज ऑल द कैरियस टीथ एंड मार्जिन्स. यू कैन सी हाउ नाउ द मार्जिन्स आर एक्सपोज्ड हियर, एंड यू कैन इजली यू क्लीन हेयर. यू कैन सी आफ्टर एक्सपोज रबर डैम एप्लीकेशन, एंड हेयर all the carious tooth structure is removed easily, and teeth are now ready to get the restorations. So this is how you have to get the isolation and accessibility. And as I told you, because of the gums are closing to the gums, so you need to retract the gums to expose the tooth surface or the lesions margin, especially gingival margins, to fully restore it and get the good contouring of the cervical area, and avoiding the overhanging, and getting the smooth restoration in the area. Now the restorative materials, what could be the restorative material for this restoration of the cervical lesions? So restoration is our here, you can see here. Amalgam, non-aesthetic materials, and very traditionally with the old restoration, the gold foils or gold inlays, indirect restoration. Nowadays we are not using these all these three, gold foils, gold inlays, or the amalgam even is very little use of the amalgam here. Aesthetic materials we are used most commonly the resin composite, and resin composite with glass enamel liner, what we call the sandwich technique, and the flowable composite, and even the your glass enamel can be used, what we call the conventional glass enamel or resin modified glass enamel. Glass enamel, conventional or compomers, you know, the combination of the glass enamel and the composite, or porcelain inlay or ceramic inlay, which is again not widely used. So these are the material we use. For amalgam, you can see here a cavity class 5 amalgam restoration. Most in posterior teeth, we can use this amalgam because it's an aesthetic problem. You can't use in anterior area. But for posterior area, even you can see here, for amalgam, as I told you, that you need some box type shape preparation, and that because amalgam is non-bonded restoration, so that it's difficult to get a retention in class 5 lesion. So you need to give some retentive feature here. Sometimes a groove is given in this gingival area or in this incisal area. Sometimes in this area, you can give the retentive grooves. And sometimes these, you can see a pins, even horizontal pins could be applied to get the retention for amalgam. And here you can see again at this cavity, it's prepared that have a gingival floor that have this occlusal or the incisal floor roof, you can see, and that the axial wall, and that all that features you have to make these walls and things to get the retention for amalgam. As you can see here, amalgam restoration has been done in these three molars, and you can see here after restoration, you should do the carving, do the burnishing, to smoothening, the contouring of the amalgam, and polishing of the amalgam. And here you can see an old amalgam polished restoration, a very smooth, shiny amalgam here. And this is, you know, in terms of gingival health, amalgam is better than the composite because the amalgam have very more smooth surfaces as compared to a composite. The composite, the resin attract the plaque, and that plaque can lead to the gingival inflammation, but the amalgam is not. So that amalgam, and it's clean, and it's a very, you know, smooth surface you can see here. But problem with amalgam is that aesthetic problem. It's not aesthetic restoration, and the retention again a problem. For retention, you need to remove the tooth structure to get the box type of the cavity preparation for getting the retention for amalgam. So because of this problem, we have a bonded restoration, and that bonding to tooth surface per problem with this bonded restoration, basically you have a composite in line. And with the composite, you problem is the bonding to root surface. Actually, the cementum is there, the dentine is there. There's no enamel at all, so that is a problem. Sometimes, as you know, that's more polymerization shrinkage is the problem here. So this is a these problems involving with the composites when there is a root surface restoration. As you can see here, cavity in the root area. When you restore in a single increment, you can see gaps are there at the wall of the cavity, and the composite restoration, contraction due to the polymerization shrinkage, and that contraction leads to the gap here. And then sometimes discoloration, mostly you find the cervical composite restoration discolored with time due to the micro leakage. Or sensitivity could be there, even continue the patients complaining same sensitivity, or sometimes is a loss of the composite even due to the bonding problem. So if you use here and your niche jo figure, if you focus on that, you can see here a cavity is filled with the increment number 1, number 2, number 3. This is a way you have to reduce this polymerization shrinkage to get good sealed restoration of free of the micro leakage and all these things. better work. For glass ionomer is considered mostly the material of choice in the cervical area, and especially, you know, the forces of occlusal forces, as we discussed in case of the effraction, these occlusal forces have more pressure on the cervical area, and the flexation of the structure may lead to the loss of the enamel. And so enamel, because it's a brittle, even the material which is more brittle material have more chance of the loss due to these under forces. So the composite, if mostly if using the composite, very hybrid type of composite, very strong, it's more brittle type. So it is the fracture also occur as fracture of the enamel occur. So if you use a material which have a more flexibility, that may act better than the brittle material. So GIC, as you know, have a more flexibility than composite. GIC act like a more dentine, and composite act like more enamel. So if GIC, if you use in cervical area, because of this more flexibility, it can bear the forces of the occlusal forces, and there's the less chance of the fracture or the loss of the restoration. And GIC, if these are in the case of the non-cervical or non-carious cervical area, and if there is a carious cervical lesions, if they are the carious cervical lesion, even the GIC, as you know, the fluoride, roller fluorides and all these things. So GIC have this these advantage than the composite. It is because of the flexibility and because of the fluoride releasing effect. And because of a third thing is the adhesion. As we discussed in a composite, a problem is get adhesion with the root surface, especially with the cementum and dentine. It's not as ideal as we are have a getting retention with the enamel. So enamel is not present to compromise the adhesion of the composite, but the GIC have a good adhesion to the cementum and dentine. So adhesive property is better, and fluoride effect is there, and other things, flexibility under the forces. So these are having advantages of the GIC. So GIC, a conventional GIC are mostly as a resin modified, what we call the resin RMGIC, when we add some resins, especially hydroxymethylmethacrylate, HEMA, we add in the composite or in the GIC, and then GIC become curable, as your composite is curable, light curing. So GIC is a dual curing, it's a chemical curing and light curing as well. We show the light, it will cure. So that is your RMGIC, is a resin modified glass ionomer. So we resin modified glass ionomer could be applied in these teeth. As here you can see, glass ionomer restoration has been done in these cervical lesions. But the problem of the GIC is that you can see here, they are not so color matching, and they are have look more opaque. And if they, you can't use in anterior area, especially when patient have a high lip line, and when the smiling, during smiling, the cervical areas are exposed. So these are more opaque, as are not unpleasant on smile, and patient sometimes complain this, that the restoration is visible. So what then could be a solution? A solution, what we call the sandwich technique, and under you have to apply your GIC. Because of these properties, the adhesion to the dentine and cementum, fluoride releasing and flexibility, all that. So cover the cavity with the RMGIC and cover the RMGIC with your composite. So RMGIC become a sandwich between the dentine and between the composite. That's why we call it sandwich technique. And in cervical area, it is what we call the open or closed sandwich, because it's fully covered with your composite. Sometime in a class 2 cavity, also a sandwich technique is done. In a posterior teeth class 2, we discussed that. There is a gingival fluid again in a cervical in a root area that filled with GIC, and then cover it with your composite. But from proximal area, the GIC is open. That's why it's called the open sandwich technique. And in a cervical case, or in a class 5 lesions, it is what we call the closed sandwich technique. So apply GIC and cover it with your composite. That we call a sandwich technique. And it is a better approach because two purpose we achieve. One is that good restoration, adhesive adhesion to the dentine and the cementum with the GIC, and with the aesthetic restoration with the composite you applied. As you know, the two things are we are replacing here, dentine and enamel. So it's better to replace the dentine with your GIC and replace the enamel with your composite. So that is the composite give your aesthetic and smooth surface aesthetic. So here you can see a cervical class 5 lesions are there in these mandibular premolars, and RMGIC is applied here. Resin modified glass ionomers applied here, and this resin modified glass ionomer finally is covered with your composite restoration. So this we call the sandwich technique. At sandwich technique, it is GIC cover under the composite, and composite cover the GIC and give the aesthetic and shiny and smooth effect. Okay, so that's all about these carious cervical lesions and non-carious cervical lesions. We discussed the etiology, we discussed the restorative options, we discussed the controlling, how you control the etiological factors, and how you identify these etiological factors. So this is all about. If any questions, you can ask the question.
Excuse me, sir.
Huh?
Sir, for sandwich technique, how much deeper do we have to matlab hame jo karni hogi in kitna deep karna hoga bubbar se isko cavity remove karke?
Okay. Jaha is case mein jo abhi aapke paas case ye hai. You can see caries lesions here. Sometimes if there is a caries, you need to remove the caries. So if it is not caries, or what we call the non-caries cervical lesion, sometimes we don't need to prepare even. Just sometimes we prepare a little bit if there is a enamel or like this, or babbling sometimes with giving in a incisal area. Baki usko deep nahin karte, hum deepen nahin karte. Only we polish it and then we HN. So aap keh rahe ki deep ho taaki dono layers we can apply it. So if it is not deeper, then there's no need to do the sandwich technique. Only if it is a shallow cavity, you can seal it with your composite. Or there are some flexible composites are also available, what we call the flowable composite. Or compomer, we can use that. But for sandwich technique, either you have to apply two layers. It depend at least agar 2 mm tak ho aapki deeper already cavity. So usme deep cavity mein you can apply a GIC layer and you can apply a composite layer. Okay. So it depend aapke subjective usme hai ki cavity agar is the deep enough, you can apply both layers of the GIC. And but the, when you apply composite over the GIC, composite bonded to GIC surface, so even thin composite bhi hoga to doesn't matter, wo ho, it is bonded to surface of the GIC. Baki agar caries hai, for example in this cavity mein you can see a caries lesion is there, so you have to remove that caries. ठीक है, तो कोई कोई स्टैंडर्ड नहीं है कोई कितनी डीप होनी चाहिए आपकी.
ओके सर, थैंक यू.
ओके, कोई एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? ठीक है. Okay then.